Hello students, welcome back to our English class. Students, today we are going to start our class 10 book First Flight. The name of the chapter, the two stories about flying, part 2, that is the Black Aeroplane. This is the same chapter having the same theme of his first flight, where we learn how a seagull, at first it was afraid, she could not gather up her courage, so she could not fly, but later due to the help of her mother, it started to learn flying and she became ecstatic. She was delighted when she learned her first flight. So this is another chapter, the Black Aeroplane. This is also about the flying. Yes, from our ancient times, human beings are very much eager to fly in the air. So it is our instinct in our heart that definitely we are having the intention to fly in the air. So it started with the two Wright brothers, who for the first time we call they are the pioneer of aeroplane, the Wright brothers. So here it is also about their chapter, the Black Aeroplane, not the chapter about how we invented plane. This is about the chapter of a lesson that has been taught to us, that is courage is guided by faith. Now in this chapter, the writer Frederick Forrest, he was a pilot. So he spent so many months in his work in France. He was working in France. He was returning after a long work during his holiday. He was returning to England. What was his hometown? England was his hometown. So he was returning from France to England. And in European countries, he was returning to his house through a private plane. It was an old plane. What? Old plane. The name was Dakota. Name was Dakota and model name was DS-088. It was an old Dakota DS-088 model plane. He was returning from France to England. The story is about that how he was happy when he was returning to his house after a long work, and it was a very safe journey. There was no sign of any kind of indication that is going to face a huge cloud thunderstorm. Later, at the end of the story, it is a very favorite story of mine because the end of the story is a little bit mysterious. A little bit mystery is there. When you read the last part, you will be happy. What happened? Your mind will be full of mysterious thinking. What may be that? What happened to him? How did he overcome that? So before starting the chapter, I will be telling you another thing, that theme courage is guided by faith. And another thing that is given in the chapter his first flight, same thing we'll learn here, that whenever we are going to start a new thing, we must keep patience. Dekho, every time whenever we face any challenge, any kind of risk, we became afraid, and due to fearness we lost our faith. So actually, if you are courageous, you will definitely put faith in your heart. Agar tum courageous rehte ho to man mein believe, vishwas rahega. So this is the theme, that we must keep patience and faith. हमें पेशेंस रखना है, फेथ भी रखना है. हमें पेशेंस भी रखना है, फेथ भी रखना है. एंड नेवर वी शुड नॉट लूज आवर होप. ओके, वी मस्ट कीप पेशेंस, फेथ एंड होप ड्यूरिंग द सिचुएशन ऑफ क्राइसिस. ड्यूरिंग द सिचुएशन ऑफ क्राइसिस. And definitely we'll our courage. Our courage will help you to overcome that situation, to get out of that situation or crisis. So here also the pilot, the writer Frederick Forsyth, he was returning from France to England by a private plane, old Dakota DS-088. At the beginning it was a very clean journey, no problem was there. But when he crossed Paris, he noticed a huge mountain like clouds, stormy clouds are there in front of him. And his plane was an old model plane, so he could not, I think, go through the atmosphere. So he was having two way, either he has to return or he has to try over or crossing it from south or north. But his plane fuel tank, when he noticed that there was not enough fuel that he could cross the huge cloud in roundabout way, and he was not at all interested to go back to his to Paris. He wanted to get, or he wanted to join his family members in the morning for breakfast. So he took the risk. He started going inside the stormy cloud, and when he went inside, all became black. Nothing he could see. Just he noticed his plane was twisting. It was behaving in a very unnatural way. And what he did at the same time, when he noticed that his radar was, his compass was not working, it was not showing him any direction, any latitude, any kind of longitude, and his system control, his system or radio meter, radio by which he connect to his control room, that was not also working. So he scared. Now he is having one faith, that somehow I have to manage, I have to courageous. Although he was afraid, but he was courageous. Suddenly when he was thinking that what to do, he noticed another plane just crossed him, and he could watch that the pilot of the plane was gesturing him by his hand that follow me. So like an obedient child, he followed him, and somehow he managed to help the writer, and by guiding and by following the writer came out of the storm, and before any accident he reached near the runway and he landed. But the last part I will not tell you, it is a mystery. You have to read the chapter and you have to find out what mystery was there. What mystery was there? There was a very interesting ending is there. You have to find it out. So till now this is about the chapter. You have to read the last part of the chapter. So have a nice day.